Now to an Aussie who's made it big in movies and on TV shows, but not in a starring role. She is a stunt woman who helps to create that movie magic, all the best bits, and protect the big name stars from injury. 5 years ago, she even won the Oscars of the stunt world. It's an amazing job, but it's even more amazing when you look at how Ky Furneaux started out. Let's welcome her to Studio 10.
Yay!
Amazing. That's a big final scene from Thor, isn't it?
It was so much fun.
You were so good.
Did you grow up wanting to be a stunt woman?
You know, I didn't. I had no idea that the career even existed. You know, I never really watched television or movies myself. I mean, I was always playing superheroes, like out in the backyard with the super capes on and everything like that.
So what got you into it then?
Well, I was an outdoor guide, so rock climbing and abseiling and all that sort of thing, and I was on a school camp, and honestly, a kid just said to me one day, we were tumbling down some sand dunes, said, you should be a stuntwoman. And I guess, I had no idea what it meant to be a stuntwoman. I had no idea, you know, what all of that entailed, but it sounded like a good
idea. Is there like a stunt school or something? Like, what do you do when you decide to...
Well, there are stunt schools, but they weren't a lot around in those days. So you just sort of pull bits and pieces of skills from around. So I decided to become a fighter because it was a bit late to be a gymnast in my at my time of life. And I so I just learned kickboxing.
Look at
and
this
was Electra.
Oh, wow. Amazing.
That was super
incredible.
Fun.
Is it dangerous though? Because it looks scary.
It is dangerous because if it wasn't, the actors would be doing it. You know, so that's the thing is they do.
And do you just do stunts for women, or have you had to do stunts for men as well?
I've never done a stunt for a man.
No.
Right. So just women, and sometimes myself. You know, sometimes you get little stunt acting roles where you say one line and then get shot dead or something.
Because you've actually heard about stunt people who've died on sets.
Yeah.
You know, so it's a pretty high stakes career, right?
It is, and it's you know, I mean, you can do it safely, but in an easy day, I'll probably come off with a few bruises, and a hard day, you know, I've broken a few bones.
Do you also check the people that are working around you? Like, do you say to them, the guy pulling the ropes, did you go out last night? Did you have a laugh? I would.
Yes.
Show me your hand.
Yeah, yeah. Stuntmen, of course they went out last night. Of course they had a laugh.
They can't feel the bruises.
Yeah.
Well, I think Electra was the movie where Ben Affleck and Jennifer Garner got together, so it was very dangerous for them.
Yeah.
But you've actually injured yourself just recently, haven't you?
I did. I had a bit of an unfortunate incident. I was working on a TV show called Blind Spot, so it was fantastic. Like a girl with tattoos, she's an FBI agent.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it was one of my favourite roles I've ever played. I got to fight a lot, but about halfway through the shooting, I started to tear my hamstring off at the bone.
And what does that feel like?
You know, it's quite painful. And the doctors just kept saying, you know, like, well, you know, if you can still fight, just keep fighting. And so I fought. I fought my hamstring off the bone. So.
Wouldn't you say, I'd like a second opinion?
Most people,
what sort of doctors are they?
That's my butt screws that I now have.
So you got your hamstring screwed back onto your butt with screws.
It had to be screwed back on, yeah. But a nice bit of a cut.
I've got to say, I thought people got screwed in the butt in television. This was...
on a brighter note, you've worked with two Aussies that are probably the best guys, most down to earth. Talking about Hugh Jackman, of course, and Chris Hemsworth.
Yes.
You work for months with them.
Yeah.
Do you get to have a lot of banter and a lot of fun with them, or is it down to sort of that whole choreograph? Is it, you know?
There's a lot of downtime, you know, and some people you get to spend a lot of time with and some people you don't. And Hugh Jackman, he and I spent a lot of time on set. I actually was looking after a bit of his safety, so I'd hold his, like, wires when he was attached to wires and we would just chat. And
I
he
offered
was
to do
awesome.
That for him. Yeah. Too, they didn't give it to me.
Were you that on that day?
I did do the Oprah show. I did the Oprah show.
Now who's the boy from Oz?
But you're also a survival expert, right?
I am.
And so you've appeared on Naked and Afraid. What on earth did you have to go naked? And what on earth made you say yes?
Okay, so we were talking about the Miley Cyrus regrets. I mean, I don't have that about my time I went naked, but...
So what is Naked and Afraid?
It's a TV show that they drop you for 21 days in the middle of nowhere and you have two items, you and a guy, and you meet the guy the first time in the location.
Oh, no.
Now, That's
and the two items are a massage oil and a cigarette.
Right. You won't survive for long out there with that.
But how did you survive? Are you in the nude the whole time?
Yes.
Is that awkward?
It is awkward for about the first 2 seconds, but then you're surviving. Like, this is the most real reality TV show on television.
How did you get food? Who did you
We
get
killed
food?
It. So we ate snakes and tadpoles and anything
in
that
the
moved.
Nude, though.
In the nude. I tell you what. With a knife, yeah, but you can make weapons. But
did you cook
them? We did.
You cook. Oh.
There's so many things. the boys on the couch are going.
All right.
She said snake.
That's right. I suppose.
So what did you learn about yourself?
And that was the great thing. I had a survival book for women coming out, Girls Own Survival Guide, and I learnt that the attitudes I'd written down in the book were actually ones that really do help you get through any situation.
Like what?
Well, like be positive and...
wear clothes?
Be prepared. Wear clothes. I mean, I would have killed for a pair of shoes, you know. Yeah. They held up undies
but
and
was
shoes.
There any romance?
Oh, no. Okay. Oh, it's filthy. You haven't brushed your teeth for 21 days.
Did you not try and fashion, like, a little loincloth
or something?
I did.
I had a happy birthday balloon. So I found one just floating in the swamp. So I tied a bit of string around my waist, a bit of root, I think I found, and tied it around my waist and then put the happy birthday balloon over that. So
don't laugh, boys.
And then later on we killed an animal and I made a bra from the fur of the animal.
But still, what a way to go. now, you know how to throw a punch.
I'm being bullied.
Now, you know how, the whole point of being a stunt person, you know how to throw a punch, get hurt and make it look real.
Yes.
Can you show me how to, are you going to punch
me? After all these comments, yes.
Okay.
The first time, it doesn't matter.
All right,
okay.
So
what are we going to do? Are you going to punch me?
Yes, I can show you how it's done.
Okay.
And then you're going to punch me. But the trick is all about the camera angle, so you're not really going to make contact, okay?
Okay.
So the trick is I'm going to go like this.
Yep.
Or you're going to go like this and I'm going to sell it.
Okay, so I'm gonna.
You're gonna punch it.
Oh, okay. This feels very wrong. Oh. Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Okay.
Angry.
Well, technically, you're probably stronger than me. So. Okay, you ready? What's my motivation? What have you done? We're naked in the jungle.
Right. I've stolen your favourite knife.
That's right.
I don't know.
You've gathered my nuts. That came out of wrong. Okay. All right. Let's try it. Let's try it again. Okay. You ready? I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
Are you okay? I hope you sold that.
No, that was brilliant. That was amazing. Don't do that at home, kids.
No, absolutely not. Ky, you are a legend. Yeah. Thank you so much for being with us.